X-Play, TV's most watched video game show.
Today on X-Play, Adam and Morgan's first impressions on Rockstar's Grand Theft Auto 4. Find out just how good it looks. Then we go on location to look at a Nazi-controlled America in Turning Point: Fall of Liberty and see why the developers say the game deserves a second chance. Plus, our virtual audience takes the studio by storm. X-Play puts in some FaceTime with you, the viewers. Lock the doors. It's game time.
Welcome to X-Play, the soft, chewy center of the gaming universe. My name is Morgan Webb.
And my name is Adam Sessler. Introductions aside, it's Friday, February 8th, and we're coming to you from the G4 Studios in Los Angeles.
On today's show, Adam and I spent a little quality time with some folks from Rockstar last night, and we got to see Grand Theft Auto 4. We're going to tell you all about it, including brand new screenshots. Then we'll go on location to look at Turning Point: Fall of Liberty. This alternative history shooter got a bad rap after its demo was released, though it might not be justified.
Then the inmates will be running the asylum as we let our virtual audience into the studio. Any topic is fair game except questions on 18th century French poetry. I don't know anything about that. Plus, if you've dreamed of being covered in balls or of photographing people covered in balls, check out what it's like to do mocap in today's Will Work for Games. But first, let's go to Morgan for all of today's top stories and our gaming update.
Thanks, Adam. PlayStation 3 owners might finally get a new Twisted Metal game. Before releasing the extra twisted edition of Twisted Metal for the PlayStation 2, David Jaffe, the game's creator, promised a hidden message in the game would reveal his company's next project. Shortly after, a handful of diehard Sweet Tooth fans were able to decipher the hidden message, which revealed that Twisted Metal was heading to the PlayStation 3. Kotaku's Brian Crescente recently spoke with Jaffe, who confirmed the hidden message was correctly deciphered. Now, we've since contacted Sony for comment, and SCEA spokesperson responded by saying, quote, "We have not made any announcements." Thanks for that. David Ortiz, the lead producer for the Madden NFL series, has resigned from his position at EA Tiburon. While official reasons for his departure are still unconfirmed, EA spokesperson Tyrone Miller tells X-Play, quote, "David's been a valuable part of our team at EA Tiburon, and we wish him the best." Dale Jackson, an EA veteran for more than a decade, continues to lead the Madden NFL development team. Well, Major League Eating has partnered with San Francisco-based publisher Mastiff to develop competitive eating games. Yes, you heard that correctly, and it is very disgusting. Major League Eating the game will apparently play like a fighting game, with burps and belches acting as a few of the game's weapons. Charming. While further details have yet to be confirmed, it's likely that players will have to eat food as fast as possible while trying to avoid throwing it all up. Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare was recently awarded two Interactive Achievement Awards. The game took home top honors for Overall Game of the Year and Console Game of the Year. The awards were announced at this year's DICE Summit, which is taking place in Las Vegas, Nevada. And be sure to tune in to X-Play next Monday when we'll cover the show floors of this year's DICE Summit to bring you the latest straight from the City of Sin. Now that is all for today's gaming update. Be sure to visit us on the web at g4tv.com/xplay to continue getting all of today's up-to-the-minute video game news. But now, let's go over to Adam, who has the latest on a first-person shooter with an alternate look at history.
A competitive eating game. Thanks, Morgan. Last month, Spark Unlimited released a demo of their alternative history title, Turning Point: Fall of Liberty. The demo was met with such harsh criticism, the company wished there was an alternate timeline where demos never existed. In the interest of second chances, we went on location to Spark Unlimited offices to get the real scoop on this game. What if history turned out different?
For the past 2 hours, our country has been at war.
If Hitler's war machine rolled over England and then trained its guns on the great big apple of liberty itself. We were so curious to see what Nazis running down Fifth Avenue would look like that we went down to developer Spark Unlimited to talk with Dean Martinetti. Well, I'm joined by Dean Martinetti. He's the senior producer on Turning Point: Fall of Liberty, and it's good to see you.
Hey, buddy. How are you?
Doing well. Let's just start off with the fact that while this is a World War II game, you're not exactly the most historically accurate World War II game out there.
It's a what-if scenario. It's a what-if Winston Churchill died when he came out to talk to us about helping them push the Germans back in Europe. He gets struck by a cab in New York City. Now, in real life, he does get struck by the cab, but he walks away from it in our story.
Carson, you're the best shot.
Now, the character you play in this, as opposed to a lot of World War II games, you're not really a soldier. You're just kind of the everyday guy. And how does that kind of dovetail back into the gameplay and how you're going to play it?
We were like, how cool would it be if he was just an average blue-collar worker that gets caught up in all of this, and the only thing he's thinking of is, I got to get out of here, man. I got to survive.
So, obviously, a lot of the stuff that we've seen from the game already puts it squarely in New York City. Are you pretty much just in urban New York, or does it expand further out?
New York City, Washington, and then we take you back to England. Eventually, through the course of the game, you realize there still are people that haven't been completely subdued by the Nazis.
How do you kind of sell Turning Point Fall of Liberty to someone who's looking for a first-person shooter?
It's a simple and fun game. It's a game that you can pick up and put down at any time, and just get in and get out of it. It's basically an homage to classic first-person shooters.
Well, Dean, thank you so much for joining us today.
Hey, thanks for having me, man.
Dean, can't wait to play.
Thanks for stopping by.
At the end of the day, don't go buy the demo. While the verdict's still out on Turning Point, there are plenty of alternative history games to try in the meantime. In today's X-List, we take a look at five of our favorites.
At number five, we have Ring of Red for the PS2. This tactical game from Konami poses the question, what would have happened if the U.S. didn't drop the bomb? The answer, mech battles. At four is Shadow Hearts from the New World. In this alternate history, there are monsters.
Just ahead of that is Crimson Skies. The country is fractured after the Great Depression, and everyone takes to the skies. It's more fun being poor and hungry in the air. At number two is a personal favorite, Resistance Fall of Man. This game shows you what a united Europe brings, Russian alien terror.
And our number one pick is BioShock 2007's Game of the Year. It shows a terrifying past where Ayn Rand and George Orwell throw up into the general consciousness.
All right, but now let's move on to a game that might make history. Last night, Rockstar Games invited us to take a look at the long-awaited and top secret Grand Theft Auto 4.
Now, we cannot talk about everything we saw, but we do have some first impressions of the game as a whole. The first impression was just sort of the size of the game now.
Yeah.
I know the last game was also incredibly large, but this game's a lot more dense.
Exactly. I mean, it really does feel like a metropolis. What's also really neat is that it's not like, it is still like the old Liberty City that we know from Grand Theft Auto 3.
Right.
It suddenly felt familiar, but so much detail inside of it.
And
it,
for example, like almost all of the rooftops you're going to be able to go onto and explore and use in your combat and your strategy.
Yes, and it definitely leads to stuff like sniping. There's a lot of fun that can be had from very, very high up on a rooftop. And with the sniping, I think one of the other things that people would be most immediately impressed with is what they've done with the combat.
Yeah.
It's really nothing like you play before in Grand Theft Auto. It's really, Gears of War might be the closest similarity of the way that the combat is handled in the game.
No, it looks great. I mean, you're going to have more fun when you get out of the car, because I know before, you sometimes...
It's like that skill level, you sometimes need it to actually shoot people in like the time limit or whatnot.
Yeah.
But there's a cover system.
Yeah.
And it really opens up the battle to something you have to think through, which is good.
Right. You're not just sort of running and gunning and hoping that you make it through.
Exactly. I think the other thing that both of us were noticing was the level of detail.
Yes.
Like the small details, the stuff that's going to take a while for you to play the game to start to pick up on.
Well, just like the way he moves, for example, the way he's going to, you know, run downstairs, it feels very realistic. And he's standing on a curb, half not standing on a curb. His body reflects that. And you don't really realize, but your brain picks up on that information when you're playing a different kind of game and thinks fake.
Exactly.
But it helps like bring it up to the next level. So
and you're going to see that with the physics when things fall on cars. It's really, at the end of the day, both of us were amazingly impressed. I just want to play this game now. That's all I can say.
All right, stay right there. X-Play will be back in just a minute. We are only just getting started.
Coming up on X-Play, our Will Work for Game series heads into the green screen, ball-filled world of motion capture. Then, we answer all your questions about Super Smash Bros. Brawl in our virtual audience. Plus, Devil May Cry is quickly dissected in spoiler theater. We'll be right back.
...240 miles above the Earth when IMAX needed to power their camera. They trusted Duracell.
Weeknights at 8:30, only on G4.
We've all heard the bad reviews on video game movies. What do you two think are the actual best video game movies out there.
Welcome back to X-Play. Thank you for your question, Ryan. That's a tough question.
They're all really bad. All of them.
It's just, yeah.
I really got nothing.
The one thing I would say is that, you know, movies that are based on the concept of video games tend to do better. David Cronenberg's Existence is the best of that bunch.
Yep, Tron.
Tron, once again. Stuff. Yeah, it was a good one. I don't know, I kind of have a soft spot for The Wizard with Fred Savage. You know, they showed Super Mario Brothers 3 in it, and so it was kind of exciting. Really a very expensive preview. That's really all that you can really describe The Wizard as, but anyhow.
Well, as the use of motion capture grows in video games, so does the demand for people who know their active markers from their semi-passive imperceptible markers, and who doesn't? But if you're confused, you should pay attention to this. It will work for games. You saw a Mortal Kombat motion capture session when you were a kid, and now you decided that your life path leads to a computer, a soundstage, and a spandex suit covered in balls. Hold your horses, Sub-Zero. You might not know as much as you think about being part of a motion capture team. Then again, how hard could it be?
I have clients approach me and say, hey, I want to shoot this type of motion on this day. I need to do a large part of my job is to facilitate exactly what they need. Some of them need props, you know, built or acquired, and some people need stunt work, and I have to go out and get those people.
My job is acquisition of the data, also quality control. As soon as it's captured, I start reconstructing it and making sure that the data's looking good for the producers. We need to know right away that, you know, the quality is good, or else it's hundreds of thousands of dollars that could be lost that day.
I can get a phone call at any time saying, hey, James, next week I want to shoot 15 guys falling from the ceiling. You know what I'm saying? And that's not out of the realm of possibility.
Yeah, I still do laundry here. All the suits that you see the mocap actors do, I actually gotta get in there and wash them. So that's probably the dirtiest, but you know, not the most exciting part of the job.
Okay, so I was wrong. As for getting into mocap, well, it depends on who you ask.
Here at Sony, I started out as an intern.
Quite honestly, I got in because I knew somebody.
To have like some kind of education background, companies look at that now. You know, they just don't want to hire somebody, you know, right off the bat, you know, if they have no technical experience at all.
You can either take the school route or you could probably just go straight to the companies and show up at the door and introduce yourself and try to get in.
So go to school or don't. Honestly, it seems to work either way. Regardless, you'll be working hard, but if it's what you want to do, it's worth it.
Find a good solid school and then follow your dreams. That's basically it. Hard work.
Yeah, I'll take anyone that wants to work hard at it, you know, someone that's passionate about it. Absolutely.
Oh yeah, and one more thing.
If you came to work for me, you're gonna get in the suit, absolutely. It's just part of the gig.
Don't forget that G4's new nightly block of totally foreign shows, Duty Free TV, takes over the airwaves every weeknight at 8:30. The block features shows unseen here in America, like Super Big Product Fun Show and unbeatable Bonzuke. If you want to see some jaw-dropping bizarre foreign shows, stay tuned. Check out g4tv.com/dutyfree for more info and updates.
Sounds great. Now, when X-Play returns, we're joined by you, our virtual audience, to talk Super Smash Bros. Brawl, review scores, GDC, and more. But first, let's take a look at who rules the roost in Team Fortress 2.
Protest an open rebellion at eBay. The feed starts in 60 seconds.
For brand new and free gifts shipped today.
I'm glad I called.
Welcome back to X-Play. There comes a time in every television host's life when you have to come out of your ivory tower and check in with the common man. That's now. Let's check in with our virtual audience powered by StickCam.
All right, let's start the team play. First up, we're going to talk with David. Go ahead, David.
Hey, Adam Morgan. Super Smash Bros. Brawl has many different controller options. Which one do you like the best and why?
You know, I've actually played with the GameCube controller mostly. I just like it because it's pretty much exactly the same as it
right.
used to be.
And exactly. If you played it on the GameCube, yeah. you're going to be very familiar. Having said that, using the Wiimote and the Nunchuck, I found to be actually much easier to figure out than I'd originally thought. Just,
right.
just using the analog stick just, you know, to help with the jump, I actually felt it was a little bit easier on that one than on some of the others.
So if you have both, you should probably try both and see which one you like best. Yeah. Well, thanks for the question, David. Next, we have Josh coming at us from California. What's on your mind?
Hey, guys. How's it going? This week, you guys rated a lot of games, 3 out of 5, including Devil May Cry 4. I was wondering, why were you guys so harsh on these games?
I don't think we were harsh.
The 3 isn't harsh. We're not really saying it's a bad game. But really what it came down to, as we talked about it in the head-to-head yesterday, is that they're really just graphical improvements. And we didn't really see them take advantage of all the horsepower of the new consoles
right.
to really create a new game based on that license. You know, we're looking for more innovation out of our games right now.
And we really do it for you guys. We don't want you to get the game and pick it up and be like, they should have been more harsh on this game. I just wasted $70 on this game.
And as we say every time, if you like the old style of those games, you will be satisfied.
Yeah.
But it's not going to broaden that audience to people that haven't played Devil May Cry
exactly.
or a turn-based Japanese RPG in the past.
All right, up next, we're hearing from Lyle. What's your question?
Hello, what's going on, guys?
Hey, not too much.
What games are you hoping to see come out of the GDC conference?
A lot of games. That's what we want to see. There's a host of things. I think one of them, Force Unleashed. I'm so excited.
I mean, you guys have seen the Force Unleashed trailer. It's the huge ship coming and the guy stopping. I mean, everybody's seen that. We've played it a million times because it makes us all giddy inside. Maybe that's just me.
And it's amazing. We've been disappointed so much by Star Wars games. Yeah, I think we have unbridled expectations and hope for Force Unleashed.
You know, I hope we see a lot of really funky, creative, small games that aren't necessarily going to have a lot of hype. But hopefully we'll learn about those and we'll see some really creative ideas come out of GDC, which is what makes it so great.
And I'm crossing my fingers for a little Too Human because I'm getting this itch for this game.
We're starting to itch. We've been waiting for Too Human for quite a long time.
I have rashes on me. Okay.
Okay, next up, Steve wants to know about Mass Effect's new download pack. What can we do for you, Smee?
I was just wondering, since BioWare announced it, what do you guys think about the new pack, when it comes out at least, and how will it work for gamers that have already beat the game?
I just want to have it now because, I've played my Mass Effect a couple times over, and the idea of new content is absolutely great.
And I think, actually, it's a really good deal. I mean, you get, 90 minutes of content for not very much money? $4, $5.
Now, I'll have to admit, your other question about how it works if you have finished the game, we're not 100%, and we're actually looking into that right now. So hopefully next week we'll be able to give you an answer on that.
Because I think everyone's wondering about that. All right, rounding out the session, we have Nuno from Connecticut. What's up, Nuno?
Hey, Adam. Hey, Morgan. I just want to know, what are your favorite games right now?
Right now, I would have to say No More Heroes. That game is still just kind of stunning me with its inventiveness. The story is ridiculous, but I can't wait to see more story elements, just see how much more ridiculous the game actually becomes. And the gameplay is just oddly satisfying, though insanely difficult.
There's a lot of games out there. I haven't actually gotten into No More Heroes as much as I think a lot of the guys have.
Right.
But I've been playing Sins of a Solar Empire, so there
you exactly. Go. She plays the smart people games, and I'm like, that one already cut the head off.
Already
gonna cut the head off game. All right, well, thanks to all of you for your questions.
Up next, we've got your tickets to Spoiler Theater. You'll see the early days of the world's most feared demon hunter, Dante. The show will start in just a minute. X-Play, one of iTunes' best podcasts of 2007. From the producers of Ninja Warrior comes the ultimate competition of man versus obstacle. Unbeatable Ben's
kill odor-causing bacteria with Axe deodorizing body spray.
X-Play presents GDC 08. Come along as Adam and Morgan uncover the very latest in gaming.
This is now one of the must-have games.
And profile what's to come. It's 5 days of exclusive interviews, trailers, and demos. X-Play from the GDC starts February 18th, only on G4.
Welcome back to X-Play. There's nothing we take much more pleasure in than spoiling a good plot. With that in mind, at the end of Rambo, a lot of people die. Also with that in mind, we proudly present Spoiler Theater Devil May Cry.
If the ending of Portal makes it the thinking man's video game, Devil May Cry might just be, the complete idiot's video game.
I should have been the one to fill your dark soul with light!
Yeah, it's basically a nonstop mishmash of terrible translation and Keanu Reeves caliber performances.
It looks like we have a winner.
First, you confront the evil Mundus in his Cathedral of Ultimate Evil.
Strange and ironic that it will end the same way.
turns out that he's kidnapped your skanky girlfriend so that she can sacrifice herself to save you.
Trish! No!
Ah, Mundus breaks out of his shell and warps you into outer space.
Mundus, mother, I created as many as you want.
That's a weird offer. The game briefly turns into a shooter before reverting back to your standard Devil May Cry gameplay. Once you kill the bad guy, you mourn the loss of your loved one the only way a Demon Slayer can, by campily overacting.
I should have been the one to fill your dark soul with light!
Yeah, that line might have read better on paper. Anyway, you try to escape Mallet Island as quickly as possible, only to be stopped by Mundus yet again.
I'm not going anywhere!
Oh, did we mention Trish comes back to life? And no, they never address how that happened.
Dante, use my power!
You think Dante would be freaked out that he's dating a zombie?
It looks like we have a winner.
Jackpot. You kill the bad guy, leaving you in the middle of a crumbling tomb, which would be a problem if this game made any sense at all.
Let's rock.
The game briefly turns into a shooter again until you break free.
The sky is fair. It'll always be above everyone's head, no different.
What? You really can't make this stuff up, folks.
Like the sky. I feel like my heart is becoming clear.
Yeah, that's it. I'm out of here.
That's what happens at the end. Huh. Well, that's it for today. Be sure to be here next week for all new episodes of X-Play every weeknight at 8.
You're going to want to stick around if you want to see the world's wildest, most amazing TV around.
It's duty-free TV, G4's new nightly block of totally foreign shows, so don't change the channel. It's up next.
And we are going to see you next time.
Thanks for watching.